When we have two variables or dimensions, a 2D scatter plot is ideal to understand the relationship or pattern between two variables or dimensions in a data set. But when there are three variables, we use 3D plots. But if you have more than three dimensions, then you have to figure out how to plot them, right? So how can we plot them? We use pair plots, right? Where pairs of features of a data set are plotted. So let's say we have four features. Let's take it from the iris data set only. So we have sepal length, sepal width, petal length, and petal width. Four features. So the total number of pair plots will be 4C2, right? Because we are taking two features at a time. So the total number of pair plots will be 4C2. And here the flowers are classified as Setosa, Versicolor, and Virginica. That's the whole objective of this data set. So let me show you how pair plots are implemented for this data set. So here I have already imported the data set with pandas. So you import pandas as PD, and then you declare a variable iris equals to pd.read.csv, and inside that you mention the file name, and after that you need to declare and then after that seaborn library also. So I've imported seaborn as sns. So if I have to execute, I'll set SNS set style white grid. SNS dot pair plot iris hue species, because we want to represent species on this pair plot. So size equals to 3. Oh, species starts with. So here you can see all the features are plotted. You can draw you can draw observation from whichever two features you wish to compare, and you can draw observations, let's say, from either petal length and sepal length. So this will be the graph, right? Like this will be the plot between the sepal length and petal length. Let's say you want a plot between sepal width and petal length. So this will be the plot between sepal width and petal length. You can choose any plot between any based on your objectives. If we choose the feature petal length and petal width, right, you can clearly see that if the petal length is less than 2, then the flower definitely belongs to the species Iris setosa, right? And for Versicolor and Virginica, there is also a range which you can declare that petal length between, let's say, 3 and 5. 3 and 5 is Versicolor, right? And beyond 5, petal length beyond 5 is Virginica. However, there is an overlap between Versicolor and Virginica, but still the model is fairly workable. We can use it to distinguish between the species based on their different features. However, pair plots does have limitations. It performs well on 4 or 5 features, but as the number of features increases, let's say 20 features, then the number of pair plots will be 20 C2, which is a huge number, right? Which will be very difficult to comprehend, right? And then, and because of that, there are more advanced tools, which we'll discuss in future videos.